Hello everyone, and welcome to my Paintology YouTube channel. I've been a traditional artist for some time now, and I've recently moved to digital drawing. I use all types of devices to do my digital drawing, and I've come to appreciate the subtle differences between each of them. These differences become more apparent as you take them through its paces with the Paintology app. In this new series of videos, I'll be posting my take on the performance of each of these devices from an artist's point of view. Hopefully it will help you make your own decisions. There are no sponsorships of any kind. These are my personal opinions and views. We're going to review these two amazing tablets, the Samsung S6 Lite to my left and the Huawei Mediapad M5 Lite to my right. On first impressions, they seem both similar in performance and specs, and I will be taking both of these tablets through a drawing each using the Paintology app. So let's get started and see how these two compare head to head. Hello, welcome back. As you can see, I have the two tablets side by side. To my left is the Samsung S6 Lite, and to my right is the Huawei Mediapad M5 Lite. As you can see, they're slightly different in size. The Huawei Mediapad is slightly thicker when I'm looking flat, and also a little bit bigger, as you can see, compared to the Samsung S6. But this is probably acceptable because the Huawei Mediapad came out a year and a half before the Samsung S6, and also the cost is like about a third less than the Samsung. So let's take a look at the power. Let's turn it on. The power on the Samsung is on the top, as you can see, and then the power on the Mediapad is on the right. So that's fine. Let's go back to the home page, and both screens are very good from first impressions, and both are acceptable for viewing Netflix or any other video streams that you care to watch. And then I'll go through that in a little bit more detail later on. Okay, let's take a look at the Samsung S6 Lite in a bit more closer detail. As you can see, the tablet is more rectangular in shape than the Huawei, and it's thinner. I would say it's very slightly thinner. The power button is on the top here. The volume up and down is to the top as well. And then the USB power is located on the right, as you can see here. The speaker grills are to the right and left of the tablet. The headphone jack here. So this is quite a nice tablet. I mean, I like it for drawing, which is the whole purpose of the video, is to test this against the Paintology app that I'm going to show you in more details later on. I did have an issue with this initially with the tablet, in that I didn't know where the mic was, and I accidentally pressed, put the phone nib that you have, the small nib, through there, and I think I pushed the mic inside, even because it wasn't labeled clearly, because of another one here. There's another mic, sort of a mic input. I actually assumed that I was going to put the SD card through here, and this apparently is the SD card and the LG card holder as well, the SIM card. So this is what we have here, and I will next go on to show you the Huawei tablet. Okay, here we have the Huawei M5 Lite. Also feels good to the hands, and it's quite curved, more curvaceous than the Samsung S6, I would say. And as you can see at the top, it has grills which I'm assuming are the speakers, and even at the bottom we have the grills, and the side is where we have the power button and the volume up and down, and to the left we have the USB cable here and the headphone jack here, the SD card holder here. So all in all, I mean, it feels good. The camera to the top left here feels good, and I have used this to draw, which I will show you later on, and compare Paintology with the S6 Lite. So I will now go ahead and show you some of the sound and the video quality of each. We're going to test the sound and the video quality of this Huawei compared to the S6. So let's go to Netflix, which many people are familiar with, and let's pick out one video. The sound is pretty good, and it's quite loud. You can take it loud. And I believe there's sound coming from all four sides. So the video quality is pretty good now. No lag or whatsoever. This is the Samsung S6 Lite, and we're going to take it through the sound and vision. Open up Netflix. I already have the previous video opened here. So volume, as you know, is on the top. It's actually a similar volume level compared to Huawei, so I may have been mistaken. It's quite fairly loud, and it's very similar to Huawei Mediapad. Let's go forward.
And talk we will, but first.
Sound is overall similar. So we have the Paintology app open on the Samsung S6, as you can see here, and I'm going to use my fingers instead of the actual stylus right now. I don't think there will be any difference, but I just wanted to show you, demonstrate that to you. So let me use my fingers. It's with a blank canvas here. And quite fast, no lag whatsoever. Yep, it's really good, and obviously I've used this to make drawings on the app through the Paintology app. So let's use the pen as well and see if that makes any difference. Not really, except it does feel comfortable. The pen actually feels good, and I'll explain it in more details when I come to do the drawing. There, as you can see, feels good. It's not very hard as the Huawei Mediapad M5 Lite. I'll show you their pen. This one has actually got a plasticky feel to it, so it's not very like you're hitting against a glass, and it's actually quite pleasant to draw. It was only when I made another drawing yesterday where I required to do a lot of shading, coloring, I decided to give up this pen and use standard hard pen that was more easier to glide over the glass. So even though a lot of people will criticize the fact that drawing on glass can be awkward, sometimes it's actually quite beneficial. So now we're going to do the Paintology. You can see it loads quite fast. Let's go to the draw. So this is the pen, and I will explain to you why I have this sort of this plaster looks, it is actually plaster wrapped around. I'll explain in more details because I draw quite a bit, and you probably understand that the comfort of the pen is essential to drawing. So let's go to the draw. Okay, I was going to use my fingers first. Go to the blank canvas. So that's the shade tool. So I should go back to the line tool. If I were to make one criticism about this, about the Huawei, it's not as fast. There's very subtle difference. Because I draw a lot, I can see that there is extremely a subtle difference between the speed. This doesn't go on as fast as the Samsung S6. So you can actually expect that based on the fact that this is a third of less than the price of the Samsung S6. So there has to be some compromise, but still, nevertheless, it's a good drawing. I don't think anyone will draw at this rate of speed anyway. So let's use the pen. Do the same thing with the pen. Let's just first. So as you can see, that has a glass. You can hear the tapping on this, and it is quite fast. I would, because you know, I'm trying to draw very quickly on the canvas, as you can see. So all in all, you know, it's a good drawing pad, and that's what I will actually show you in the next segment. So I'm going to show you a drawing that I did with this Huawei Mediapad and using the pen. And I will explain a bit more about this pen. It's very smooth to the touch. It's okay for people who don't want to use it as seriously as I do in drawing. But when you're drawing, I need to have a good grip. I found that my fingers were dry to the touch, and this seemed like a good, this made the whole world of difference to the way I felt about the drawing. And so that's why I wrapped this around. With the actual stylus of the Samsung, they probably put a little bit of thought behind this. Even though it's slimmer, it's still okay for holding and drawing. And it's not smooth like the Huawei Mediapad. It's very metallic and smooth. This is more plastic, and it has a nice long-term feel to it, and I'm perfectly fine using this to draw on the Samsung S6. So let's look at one of the drawings that I did here. So I think this drawing, which is supposed to be a photorealistic drawing, which I have been doing recently, took me probably like 2-3 hours, I'm not sure. But the feel of this drawing was slightly different to the Samsung S6, because it's more on a glass surface, and it had some difference to the feel, but the overall drawing in this case is the same. So in terms of lag or anything between the two drawings, I didn't see it. I did another similar drawing to this, which was a packet of crisps on the Samsung S6, which I'll show you. That is very similar, and I didn't find any discernible difference between the two. The drawing was fine. As I said, the only difference was the pen. The pen didn't feel nice, so halfway I wrapped this plaster around it, and it felt good. So, and also because of the glass, so as you can see, you know, the glass touch can have a little bit of effect on that. So if you want to see a video of this, and so it's 3 hours is a good time for testing the performance of the tablet, and I was aware of how it behaved compared to the Samsung and both tablets, and they both felt very fine in terms of speed, and I didn't have any problems with either of them. So if you will see the links below for the video of this drawing that I did, and I'll show you the Samsung S6 next. So here we have the Samsung S6 Lite with the similar drawing in black and white that I did a while ago. And again, the attempt was to make a photorealistic drawing. It took similar times to the Huawei, the peanut bag that I did, the KP Peanuts. And as I've said before, there was no difference. I would say, if anything, the feeling was a little bit better with this pen, only because it had a plastic nib, and as I said, a nice plastic feel, even though the actual barrel is quite small, thin, it still nevertheless felt good in my hands. And it took similar times, and I took, again, the video link you'll find of this drawing in the links section below the video. And I used the grayscale, so you can see that I was able to do this quite rapidly because I had the grayscale mode here. And all of this drawing was done with this shade brush tool here. You can see here. So that's all I needed, and then I naturally zoomed in for these smaller details like here, so you can see some of the the human errors of not being able to do it correctly. But when you go far, you'll see the drawing can take a different shape. So I hope to bring you more of these reviews using the Paintology app. I believe that to really put tablets through its paces, you need to test the same application through the tablet. So in that way you can see the differences. So I'm not just talking about a simple drawing, I'm talking about three long hour drawings here, as you can see. And I've done similar drawings on the phones, quite a few phones that I have, including my P30 Lite, the Pixel, and I can tell you the Pixel 1 that I got, as compared to the P30 Lite, the performance is so different because the drawing is, the actual drawing was quite laggy. So that obviously shows the power of the CPU that the phone had. So I'm hoping to bring you more of these reviews, and so please subscribe and like if you've enjoyed this video, and so I can continue to bring you more of these reviews through Paintology. Thank you for watching. Until again, bye bye.